Hey lovelies! Okay, so by now you've probably already seen the Instagram and social media posts with regards to my new tattoo, and there it is! You'll notice it's on a very particular finger. So, in 2014, when my mom was sick and she was in the hospital, she kept repeatedly giving the nurses the finger, like, regularly. And she was right-handed. I should have got it on this hand, but I think I'm going to get my mom's birth year on this hand, on this finger, so it'll be 1952-0919. And so she kept doing it. One day, this lady came that had babysat us as kids. I'm not going to name her name because I don't want her to feel bad if she watches these videos. But my mom kind of couldn't stand her. So picture this, my mother, excuse me, thank you Brickworks, my mother, frail as can be, and fucking dying of cancer, this woman turns around to talk to me, and my mother, the fucking asshole that she is, behind her back to me, looks at me and is like, took all I could not to burst out laughing. And so I decided then, when my mom passed away, that I was going to get this tattoo. I didn't know when. I didn't know what I was going to do with it. So I lost my wallet a couple of weeks ago. I don't know. Do I have it here? It's probably in my purse. Hold on. The new wallet. Thank you, Bay Days. This wallet was very expensive, but with Bay Days on, it was pretty cheap. I'm sorry, not cheap. It's not Walmart. It was affordable. So, I lost my wallet when I was hanging out with my friend Sam. We were watching RuPaul's Drag Race. And, when I went into the bank, I got a new bank card. I didn't look at my card at all, whatsoever. Then, when my friend Sean was over, my co-facilitator for my trans 101 classes at Ryerson University, we were going to buy Deadpool, and so I was adding my card information into my iTunes, and when I did, I'll do this, but you know what? I'm going to superimpose the card over top of it anyway, but when I did, if you see right down there, I looked down putting the information into my iPhone, and then my eyes started to well up with tears, and Sean was like, "Are you okay?" And I was like, "No." I was like, "Look at this. The expiration date on my new debit card is actually my mom's birthday, September 19th. And it was weird because like I said, I had been wanting to get this tattoo for so long and had been contemplating it and contemplating it. And then all of a sudden this card, sort of cemented the whole thing. And so the reason I wanted to get that tattoo, I have to like twist my, cause I don't know. Oh, there we go. Oh, that was a lot easier, Samantha. The reason I wanted to get this tattooed on my middle finger was for my mom, and getting that bank card was the sort of sign from the universe that was like, that's the tattoo you need and want. And so also, by the way, on the day that Sean came down, as he was fooling around, I decided to join Grndr. So, first of all, yes, it's actually really me on Grndr. I have actually gotten half a dozen or so messages asking if it's actually the real Samantha Lozon on Grndr. If you see me on Grndr, it says Samantha, it's got a kiss, it's got my little heart thing. It's definitely me. The thing is, folks, you know, I don't go to clubs and I don't party. I'm not into drugs like a lot of other girls are these days. They were back in the day, too, but, I mean, now it just, they're a lot more open about it. I'm not into those things. And so, my only recourse of dating is to try and find a date on an app. I, like I said, I don't go to clubs. I'm not going to randomly walk up to some hot guy in a street corner and be like, hi, how you doing? Want to go on a date with a mwah? As I pull out my Saturn from my purse. Like, I don't do that stuff. And so, I just thought that I would join Grindr. And I have to say that I've had a lot of, like, positive experiences so far. I didn't even know that trans people went on Grindr, let alone actually met people off of it. I've met two guys now so far. I met one for coffee, and I met one to color with. Both were really great experiences, and both were kind of unexpected. They seemed like really sweet guys, and yeah, and I mean, listen, I get it. I'm looking for a relationship on a sex app. But I mean, really, if you think about it, when you're at a bar, isn't that actually an app as well? You sort of like look past and just dismiss until you find someone you like, and then you talk to them and hopefully they turn out to be someone you like. And if they're not, then you move on and you dismiss until you find someone else. Real life is basically just like a dating app. Only difference is that I don't have to fucking say hello to your goddamn face. And I don't have to get out of my pajamas. I mean, of course, on a date, I get out of my pajamas, but at least if I'm like, I can get up in the morning and like answer all my messages and ta-da! Just saying. I am talking to a couple of different guys because they all seem really nice. And I have to say this. I mean, Grindr, you know, two thumbs up. I was on Tinder and I had a serious issue with the fact that I was trans and they kept blocking my account. And so it's nice to be on an app that is GLBTTIQQ friendly, where you can be yourself. And that's kind of awesome. You know, because I'm not fucking getting any goddamn younger or any more sober either. I know that you want to hear about why I quit Rexall. I promise you that update is almost ready and it will be available on May 16th, 48 hours after my official end date at Rexall. Don't watch the video expecting me to be nasty and mean. I am going to be as factual as possible and keep it good. I genuinely enjoyed working at Rexall. I genuinely enjoyed working with the people that I worked with. My issues were above and beyond other things, and those things you will hear all about on May 16th, I promise. With Mother's Day coming up, I thought that I would do something a little special for my mom, and yeah, it's something really simple and really nice, and I hope that you all really like it.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here. Somebody.
enjoyed that little snippet video that I did. I hope I don't get sued by Beyonce for using her song, because I really loved it. And it's one of my all-time favorite Beyonce songs that has ever existed. Thank you all, as always, for taking the time to watch my videos. Like I always say, you know, the most valuable commodity that we have in our lives is our time. And the fact that you take that and you use it to watch my videos really makes me feel really special. So I get it. I get that I make you feel special, but I need you to know that you make me feel special as well. I think that I'm actually going to do a tattoo video where I talk about all of my tattoos. If you're interested in seeing something like that, comment in the comments below and we will get on it. I'm saying a lot. I'm super, super, super excited this weekend to head into Hamilton, Ontario to go to Che Burrito. I don't know if they sell burritos anymore, but still, whatever. In Hess Village, my dear friend Scott McDonald has allowed me the opportunity to film on his patio in Hess Village, which I think is going to be kind of amazing. I'm going to be there with my very special guest, Jackson Gates. And so you will see that actually in a week. You won't see it now. Oh, I know, it sucks. You have to wait. Ah, that's the teaser. As always, thank you so very much for tuning in. I love you all so very much. Please never, ever, ever forget to comment right down there, right below. Share with every single one of your friends and subscribe. I will catch you all on the flip side. Bye.